Now let's move on to some simple mathematical expressions involving factorials. This. How do we evaluate this? I would suggest that you pause this lecture here and solve this expression before proceeding. Before we look at the correct solution, let's look at a common mistake that students make. They disregard the factorial function and divide 8 in the numerator by 4 in the denominator. And so the expression reduces to 2 factorial over 3 factorial, which would be equal to 2 over 6 or 1 upon 3. This is just not right. Factorial is a function, and as is the case with other functions, you cannot simply isolate the argument from the function just like that. To make it simpler, when you see a factorial of a number in a mathematical expression, you cannot just operate on that number. You'll need to expand the factorial first. Let's look at the correct solution. That should clarify my point. In order to solve this expression, we expand the factorials. Upon expansion, it would look like this. Once we do that, we are left with the usual operands. So we cancel things out according to the rules of division. And we get the final answer, which is 280. Very different from 1 upon 3. Let's consider another example. 6 factorial minus 2 factorial. Now again, we are not dealing with 6 and 2. Instead, we have their factorials, 6 factorial and 2 factorial. And so you cannot just say 6 minus 2, 4, so 4 factorial. No. Here again, we need to evaluate the factorials first. 6 factorial is equal to 720, 2 factorial is equal to 2. Therefore, 6 factorial minus 2 factorial is equal to 720 minus 2, which is equal to 718. So I repeat, be careful when you are working with expressions involving factorials. Do not treat the factorials as your usual numbers. Expand them first. Only then can you perform the operations on them.